And now call the meeting to order. Can we all please raise our right hand for the national anthem, please?
Sorry, one second.
A very good evening to everyone. Today we have amidst us Dr. Siddhant Bhargava, who is the co-founder of Food Darzi. Can I a warm welcome, Dr. Siddhant? Can I have Pooja introduce Dr. please? Pooja?
Yeah, hi. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm pleased to introduce to you all our speaker today, Dr. Siddhant Bhargava. He is a ketogenic diet specialist, a celebrity nutritionist, a co-founder of Food Darzi, and a fitness and a nutritional scientist at JG's Fitness Center. Siddhant has shaken up the conventional nutrition ideas and affirms that there is no one-size-fits-all policy to meeting fitness goals. He has consulted clients to decode diets and make an educated choice towards healthier lifestyle. After having completed his MBBS from Nair Hospital in Mumbai, Siddhant proceeded to co-found Food Darzi, a health and a nutrition company that prepares customized meals based on individual dietary requirements coupled with fitness goals. Siddhant has consulted over 3,500 clients, including some esteemed celebrities such as Alia Bhatt, Parineeti Chopra, Sonam Kapoor, Sara Ali Khan, Sonakshi Sinha, Abu Jani, and Sandeep Khosla, to just name a few. Siddhant's unique perspective and medical legitimacy is undoubtedly the driving force behind the brand's success story. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Dr. Siddhant Bhargava.
Wow. That was a great introduction. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you for having me here.
Welcome.
Karthike sir, thank you Smita ma'am, and thank you Sanjay sir for actually calling me here. I think Sanjay sir has done such great work because I have troubled him so much and he has had to deal with all of that. So special thank you to him So, of course, I was very excited to be speaking here because my parents are Rotarians, my grandparents are Rotarians. I used to be at the Rotaract Club of the Caduceus, which was a Rotaract Club by the medical students that happened in Mumbai. So I was very excited to come to your club and speak about health, because I think health, give me just a minute, I'm switching on my parallel camera, because since I'm going to be talking, I'd rather record the entire thing for myself as well. And click record. Okay. So the reason why I'm usually excited to talk about health is because it's got too many definitions about it, right? Everybody has a different concept. And the weird part about health is that you always think, maine nahin kiya to kya hoga? Like, you will always have those examples where somebody who's been eating rasgulla, jalebi, samosa all their life, they live a very, very happy and a very, very peaceful life and absolutely nothing happens. But there's always going to be a person who's been exercising very regularly, a marathon runner, eats the most healthy things possible, and then unfortunately at the age of 45 dies due to cardiac arrest. So you always have the outliers, but I don't think that should give us confidence, or it shouldn't boost us by saying ki haan usne nahi kiya to hum kyun na kare. It's basically on the same lines that a person who smoked his entire life does not get cancer, but somebody who's been clean his entire life for some reason dies of cancer extremely early. So I don't think we should pay much heed to these outliers, and we should think about us who are regular people. And regular people need nutrition, regular people need health, and regular people go through regular diseases, which makes them regular people. And but they have to make these certain changes to actually, you know, get back to a much regular, healthy life. So I'll tell you where I actually come from. Leaving medicine wasn't really a choice. It was forced upon me. At the age of 20 or 21, I was diagnosed with this condition called lupus, which is an autoimmune condition. I speak about it very openly now because ab kya kar sakte hai to hai. But at 21, I was diagnosed with that condition, which sort of forced me to leave medicine due to the kind of medicines and things like that which I was put on. At that time, I sort of realized that obviously I can't be a doctor anymore. I have the term doctor attached to me because I finished my MBBS. I have my certification, but I obviously don't treat people who are terminally ill, or I'm not a practicing doctor. I moved to nutrition because I think nutrition and medicine integrate very well together. Most of the lifestyle diseases that we have, we all know what lifestyle diseases are, hypertension, diabetes, even on the lines of a cardiac arrest, they're all lifestyle illnesses. They're very real and they can be stopped in very, very easy ways. And, you know, forget lifestyle illnesses, because I think every doctor or every nutritionist that you will hear comes up to you and says the same thing, right? Diet badlo, exercise karo, your life will be sorted. I don't think it's as simple as that. Bahut zyada factors hote hain that really determine what your body does with its health. Even after following every single thing, you still can land up with an illness, but it's basically about taking which side of chance do you want to be on. Do you want to give it your all and sort of then die after knowing that you've sort of done it all? Or do you want to completely live a carefree life and probably endanger you and your dependents around you? We all know the answer to that question. Everybody wants to live healthy, but problem ye hoti hai that living healthy is difficult, right? It's the most difficult thing that you can probably do, because diet kaun maintain karega, roz exercise kaun karne jayega. It's a tough situation. Along with that, what you also have to keep in mind is that things around you aren't improving. I am much younger than most people present at this meeting. The things that I have read, the concepts that I have learned are far different compared to what you have done in your youth. I think we all can agree with this one thing, that people are aging much faster now than they did 20 years ago. My parents look much younger at, when I compare my photos, they look much younger than me. I'm 26 years old now. They used to look much younger than when they were 26. They've aged more gracefully. And I think that's the thing with most of our, most of your population. Please don't be offended that I'm going to address you and I differently, because I'm not going to try and get ahead of myself. You obviously have way more years of experience than I have, because probably I'm 26. Most of the people here are above the age of 40. Jitna aap logo ko pata hai, obviously mujhe utna nahi pata hai. But I'm just here to give you facts and evidence, because that's completely what I treat people on. And trust me, I have treated a lot of people. Obviously, I started this company called Food Darzi. Initially, we didn't have employees. It was a startup. It was run by four young individuals. Sara ka main karta tha. I was the first nutritionist Food Darzi had. And that's where my entire experience comes from, because contrary to popular nutritionists out there, they have seen people face to face, and there is only a certain number of people that you can actually meet with face to face. But fortunately for me, I've interacted with over 100 people every day for almost 1.5 years. And that kind of a database gives me an insight into the lives of people who are above the age of 60, 50, 40, men, women, with a terminal illness, without a terminal illness, everything under the roof. And that's how I form my perspectives. So let's stop with the gyan. Let me move completely right to things which are realistic. What is a diet? Does anybody really need to diet? What is health? And is it even that important? To start with, what is health and is it even that important? It definitely is. You have known that your diabetes, thyroid, PCOD, the PCOD is something that is affecting the newer generation far more than the older generation. But these things have been there for a long period of time, right? Like somebody in your family, you've known of these people. Unfortunately, now with the kind of the air that has changed around us, the water that has changed around us, the food that we eat, things are changing. More people are developing autoimmune illnesses. What are autoimmune illnesses? लोगों को ankylosing spondylitis होनी शुरू हो गई है. People have more arthritis. Randomly, your liver enzymes will be raised. Sometimes your kidney starts failing, and there is no real cause for all of this. All of this is basically autoimmunity, and most autoimmunity stems out of one thing, which is known as inflammation. Inflammation is a much newer concept that has arisen. And the fact of the matter is that बहुत सारे जो conventional dieticians होते हैं, they don't relate to inflammation at all, because problem ये है कि उन्हें कभी वो चीज़ सिखाई नहीं गई है. So I don't blame them. If most doctors also do not still relate with the term inflammation, because inflammation is answering questions जिनके answers उनके पास नहीं थे, and the reason behind that is because they haven't been taught about it. My own father, he's sitting in the very next room. He's an ENT surgeon. He does not believe a lot of the concepts that I try and educate him about, for the sole reason that unki medical ki kitabon mein usse padhaya nahi gaya tha. So I'm going to dive right in. What are autoimmune disorders? Autoimmune disorders are all the illnesses that we cannot explain. Kisi ke baal jaldi ja rahe hain, somebody's got major dark circles, somebody's skin is erupting, you're aging much faster, your skin is becoming rough, your nails are becoming rough. All of these things boil down to inflammation. All of these things boil down to aap everyday basis pe kya khate ho. Correct? Now, being on a diet, sabke bas ki baat nahi hoti hai. Not everybody wants to lose weight. Not everybody wants to become a bodybuilder. We just want to stay healthy for yourself, for your family, for your children, whatever. That's the aim. But is there a correct way of staying healthy? Definitely. I'm going to start off by just describing. Also, if agar bahut zyada information ho rahi hai, please comment down below. Because I have this habit of giving out too much information without people actually absorbing half of it. So, jabhi bhi kuch hota hai, please interrupt me, tell me if I need to change my thought process. And at the end, we definitely are going to have like a question answer session where I will be able to answer every single one of your health related questions. And probably you will get answers which are different compared to what you've usually got. So I'll just start off. What is an Indian diet? A lot of Gujaratis here. I was hearing a lot of talks in Gujarati. I of course follow Gujarati because I'm from Jamnabai Nasi School, which is a Gujarati based school. So most of my friends are all Gujarati. So mere ghar mein bhi Gujarati khana banta hai because my Maharaj is Gujarati. Now when you look at the Indian plate, it is predominantly roti hoti hai, chawal hoti hai, dal hota hai, dahi hota hai, sabzi hoti hai, sometimes achar hota hai, papad hota hai, there's a salad right next to it. If you look at this entire meal, it's nutritious. We always qualify this as nutritious because tum kya bolte ho, roti and chawal se tumhe energy milti hai, dal se tumhe protein milta hai, dahi is good for the gut, salad is good for fiber, and you're drinking water. So according to us, our Indian diet is completely wholesome when it comes to food. Yes or no? Yes. Unfortunately, this has been propagated, and I think hum log sab, we will agree with this, that हर बंदे का एजेंडा होता है. Even that I'm talking to you, in the end I am going to talk about the company that I have, which is a nutrition company. Correct? Everybody has an agenda. Even the Indian diet is agenda based. The problem with an Indian diet is that it is very high on energy giving substances, but not very high on recovery giving substances. We understand the concept of energy and recovery. जब तुम physical exercise करते हो, mental exercise करते हो, you want to recover from all of this. If if you're only getting energy to do these activities, but you're not getting the correct substance to recover, your body's not going to like it. Correct? Let me give you an example. Carbohydrates, potatoes. Carbohydrates matlab roti, sabzi, batata, sweet potato, jawar, bajra, ragi, nachni. All of these things, sabudana because Navratri is on. All of these things are carbohydrates. They give you energy 100%. Dals, on the other hand, hame hamesha padhaya gaya tha, sikhaya gaya tha, that dals are protein rich. The answer to that is they're not. Correct? One concept broken. All of you all always have thought that dal is protein rich. And I'm assuming most of the people in the audience right now is vegetarian. How many, there are 36 members here. How many non-vegetarians? Can people comment in the chat box and tell me how many non-vegetarians? Okay, I cannot see everybody. How do I move to grid view? Okay, how many non-vegetarians? Can I am. Kartikeya sir is a non-vegetarian. Nobody else is a non-vegetarian. Okay. So Kartikeya sir obviously consumes meat. I'm not saying that you have to be a proponent of meat. I don't believe in that. I come from a vegetarian household myself. But I'm saying that dal protein nahi hai. Big concept broken. Why is dal not a protein? Because you're not consuming enough of it. Gujarati dal jo hum khate hain, the typical yellow Gujarati dal, arhar ki dal jo hum khate hain, patli hoti hai, correct? That's how we make it. 100 grams of dal has 20 grams of protein. Why am I telling you about these grammages? Because the one thing that is going to prevent you from aging, the one thing that is going to prevent you from putting on weight, the one thing that is going to help you recover from all the activities that you do is protein. Protein is the building block of life. Yahi hame padhaya gaya tha. Protein is what helps you recover. Most of us do not consume enough protein. Again, aap log socho ke bachcha hai, protein ki baatein kar raha hai, bodybuilding karta hai. Everybody around us in the health industry talks about protein, but they don't tell you why. The real funda is, how many women over here? We have 50% women, for example. Aap log apni, aap log pure ghar ka diet control karte ho. Correct? आप अपना डाइट कंट्रोल करते हो एंड ऑल ऑफ अस आर इन सम मैनर हेल्थ कॉन्शियस. ऑफ कोर्स कभी कभी द इंटरनल चाइल्ड कम्स आउट एंड यू वांट टू हैव 5 समोसास अलोंग विद जलेबी एंड द फाफड़ा ऑन अ संडे, आई एम एग्री, बट एवरीबॉडी समवेयर हेल्थ कॉन्शियस. जब आप ईयर ऑन ईयर एज यू आर एजिंग, एज यू आर गेटिंग ओल्डर, इट्स बिकमिंग टफर एंड टफर टू कंट्रोल द डाइट, इट्स बिकमिंग टफर एंड टफर टू लूज वेट, इट्स बिकमिंग टफर एंड टफर टू मेंटेन वेट. हर साल आपका वेट शायद सेम रह जाता है, बट आपकी बॉडी का शेप हल्का सा बदल जाता है. एनी 50 ईयर ओल्ड इन द ऑडियंस हियर, एट द एज ऑफ 40, इट्स पॉसिबल दैट एट द एज ऑफ 40 योर वेट वाज ऑलमोस्ट द सेम, प्लस माइनस 3-4 किलो का फर्क होगा, अनलेस यू वर रियली फिट एट दैट टाइम, बट योर वेट वाज ऑलमोस्ट द सेम. बट डज योर बॉडी लुक द सेम बिटवीन 40 एंड 50? इट डजंट. माय बॉडी डज नॉट लुक द सेम बिटवीन 20 एंड 26. One second. It doesn't look the same for the simple reason because it's not recovered as fast. That's the answer to your protein question. Dal mein protein kyun nahi hota hai? Because hum dal patli khate hain. Aapke body ko utne protein ki zarurat hai jitna aapka wazan hota hai. Supposing your body is weighing 80 kgs or your body is weighing 60 kgs. Please absorb this concept. This is one concept that is going to help you very much in life. Supposing your body is weighing 60 kgs, you need 60 grams of protein to fulfill your body's recovery needs. Why does your body need to recover? Because every step you take on the floor destroys some part of your body. Every step you take on the floor, every time you raise your hand and you get it down, some muscle mass or some cells are destroyed because every time you do a movement, there is destruction of cells, but you have to recover. आपकी अगर वेट 60 केजीज है, आपका अगर वेट 70 केजीज है, 80 केजीज है, दैट्स द अमाउंट ऑफ प्रोटीन यू नीड. ठीक है, अब आपको प्रोटीन कहां से आएगा? अगर आप वेजिटेरियन हो तो आपको दाल से आएगा, चने से आएगा, चिकपी से आएगा, काले चने से आएगा, राजमे से आएगा, लोबिया से आएगा, पनीर से आएगा, सोया से आएगा, ये सारी चीजों से आपको प्रोटीन मिलेगा. बट क्या आप खाते हो एवरीडे लाइफ में? Probably not. So this is the first change that people really must start making, is becoming aware of what you need. Correct? You do not want to just follow a person because you do not probably want to be on a diet. Nobody likes being on a diet. The reason you want to know how to construct your diet is so that puri zindagi, you have to just listen to the basic concept that have been taught to you. So the first concept is start understanding what calories mean. घर पे हम लोग सब कैलोरीज की बात करते हैं ना, ये हाई कैलोरी है, वो लो कैलोरी है, ये गुड है, वो बैड है. डू वी एक्चुअली नो व्हाट इज द फंडा बिहाइंड इट? दैट इज समथिंग दैट वी नीड टू स्टार्ट एजुकेटिंग आवरसेल्व्स अबाउट. एंड आई थिंक दिस मीटिंग इज अ वेरी शॉर्ट मीटिंग टू सॉर्ट ऑफ टॉक अबाउट द एंटायर बिट. बट वन कॉन्सेप्ट दैट आई वांट यू टू टेक होम फ्रॉम टुडे is how much protein do I need, how much protein does my husband need, how much protein do my children need, so that all of us recover quickly, so that all of us age slowly. Theek hai, I'm not going to bore you by telling you what the different protein sources are, wo sab Google pe mil jata hai. I'm only going to give you one concept about how much protein you need. Theek hai, that's one concept done. The second concept I want to talk about is how important are carbohydrates in our everyday life. Carbohydrates kya the, everybody knows. हमारा राइस, रोटी, ऑल ऑफ आर ग्रेन्स, ऑल ऑफ आर स्टार्ची वेजिटेबल्स आर कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स. द प्रॉब्लम इज दैट आर डाइट कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू मच कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, विच इज ऑल्सो कॉजिंग अर्ली और प्रीमेच्योर एजिंग. अगेन अ डिफरेंट कॉन्सेप्ट. वी नेवर थॉट दैट कार्बोहाइड्रेट, वी नेवर थॉट दैट रोटी और राइस इज मेकिंग अस एज फास्टर. आई एम नॉट सेइंग रोटी और राइस इज बैड, आई एम जस्ट सेइंग टू मच ऑफ इट मेक्स यू एज फास्टर. Why? जब रोटी और राइस तुम्हारे बॉडी में मेटाबोलाइज होती है, there are certain substances which are very natural and normal that are released into your body. These substances are basically known as, okay, I'll just give you the name, they're known as free radicals. And free radicals go and latch on to different parts of your cells, different parts of your body and destroy. Okay? If free radicals go to your kidney, they will start eroding your kidney. If free radicals go to your heart, they will start eroding your heart. Free radicals, if they go to your skin, they cause premature aging. Free radicals, if they go to your hair, they cause premature hair loss. Okay? These free radicals are released in very large quantities. जब आप चीनी खाते हो, जब आप बहुत सारा processed food खाते हो, और जब आप बहुत सारा carbohydrate rich food खाते हो. This is completely proven by research. I'm not trying to push an agenda. I'm not even trying to push a ketogenic diet. ऐसा कुछ मैं करने की कोशिश नहीं कर रहा हूँ. I'm just saying that you must be aware that free radicals are released when you do overconsumption of the bad things. जब आप बहुत सारा घी तेल खाते हो, of course, वजन बढ़ने के साथ साथ free radicals are produced. I'm not primarily going to talk about weight loss and weight gain here because it's a bahut zyada ghissa pita hua topic. Of course, you can ask me questions about it. I will be more than happy to answer. But I'm not here to lecture you ki aapko diet karni chahiye aur aapko ye khaoge to wazan kam hoga, ye khaoge to wazan kam hoga. I'm just trying to tell you how to increase the longevity of your life and how to increase the quality of your long life, because you do not want to be a cripple in your old age. I have grandparents at home. They're 87 and 85 years old. My grandfather lives a superb life. He has been controlling the kind of food that he eats. He has been exercising for the past 70 years and he lives an absolutely superb life. My grandmother on the other hand has it. My grandmother is from Lucknow. She was a spoiled girl from a very, very wealthy family where they had 12-13 kind of pakwan to eat every single day. She still eats it. And I see the difference between my grandfather and my grandmother. And my grandfather is 5 years elder than my grandma. All boils down to what they've eaten for the last 50 years of their life, for the last 60 years of their life. Correct? Free radicals ko aapko prevent karna hai. How do you prevent free radicals? Jo maine cheeze aapko batayi, reduce the consumption because stopping it is not possible. Correct? Another thing that you have to understand is that the air that you're breathing, the water that you're drinking, and the soil that your crops are grown in is far worse than what it used to be 20 years ago. 20 years ago, our food was much cleaner. I don't remember what my food was like at the age of 6, but this is what research tells you. So 20 years ago, everything was much cleaner. As of now, the food, the air and the water that you're drinking, wo hi tumhare body ke andar free radicals create kar raha hai. Wo hi tumhare body ke andar inflammation, jiski maine baat starting mein ki thi, free radicals is equal to inflammation. Inflammation causes diabetes. Inflammation causes thyroid issues. Inflammation causes a heart attack. Inflammation causes Alzheimer's. All degenerative disorders are caused by inflammation. All inflammation is caused by free radicals. And free radicals tumhare body mein banenge. Tum kuch bhi kar lo, free radicals banenge. So our major aim at health and at nutrition is to reduce inflammation to create a better functioning body. How do you reduce inflammation? One, by eliminating certain things that I just told you, which is anything which is very sugary, very processed, very fatty. Jo bhi very category mein pahunchti hai na cheez hai, wo sari cheeze buri hone wali hai. And the second thing is too much carbohydrate. Aapki thali mein, there is no need to eat 6 rotis with atlu shak, very watery dal and some raita. You can change the entire thing to a large amount of vegetable, maybe a side of some protein, because I told you that you need some protein to recover. Maybe make your dal a little more gadha instead of making it patla and reducing the amount of roti and chawal. Aisa to nahi hai that agar hum din ke 6 rotiyan and 2 bade bade plate chawal nahi khayenge, our body won't function correctly. Of course it will. Give it a shot. This is what is going to reduce your inflammation. The second thing, and which is very crucial, which probably you want to note down, are supplements. Everybody talks about antioxidants. Everybody talks about multivitamins to take. The reality behind the entire situation is a multivitamin is only supposed to be taken if you have a vitamin deficiency. There is absolutely no need to take a multivitamin if your nutritionist has just told you. Koi zarurat nahi hai. You take a multivitamin if you have a deficiency. Other than that, you eat a wholesome, nutritious diet and you're all covered. That Awaz is basically my dad walking around. Hi, Papa. I'm giving a talk for Rotarians. They are from the Bombay Club, Rotary Club of Bombay Bayview. You are which club?
Sea Coast.
He's from Rotary Club of Bombay Sea Coast. Okay. So, inflammation, what we spoke about. There are only two supplements that you want to take forever. One is an antioxidant and one is an anti-inflammatory. Inflammation ki baat ki thi, to anti-inflammatory obviously hume lene ki zarurat hai because you cannot prevent complete inflammation, but you can negate it. Haldi, turmeric, sab kaadho mein haldi jaati hai. All your Indian garam masale, they're all anti-inflammatory. Correct? Your berries, all your colored fruits and vegetables, they're all antioxidants. So you want to increase the amount of Indian garam masala that you put inside your food, and you want to increase the amount of colorful vegetables and fruits that you eat, because both of these are anti-inflammatory and antioxidants. But is this enough? Probably not. Two supplements that I will definitely recommend to you. One is omega-3. Again, sab log ne omega-3 aur omega-6 ki baatein suni hui hain. But one supplement that you definitely want to put in your everyday for your whole family, whether your child is 10 years old or whether your father is 65 years old, omega-3 is one supplement that you have to take. Omega-3 wale supplement se tumhare inflammation levels body mein apne aap kam honge. And why should you believe me on this? Because I suffer from lupus, which is an inflammatory disorder. I have managed to keep my levels of inflammation almost at zero to prevent any kind of relapse. Omega-3 supplementation mein, if you are okay, if you are ekdam thet vegetarian, you want to maybe get flaxseed supplement. But if you are okay with capsules, kyunki capsules ke covering mein kabhi kabhar gelatin aur wo sari cheeze hoti hain, GNC Triple Strength is the name of the supplement you want to buy. I don't get money by GNC. I don't even know who owns the brand. The point is that unke omega-3 mein jo correct kind ka omega-3 and the correct quantities. Apart from that, there is one other supplement that you want to consume, which could either be vitamin C or it could be vitamin E. It is an antioxidant. Vitamin C, to ye COVID time mein sab log bahut zyada le rahe hain. It is important. These two things will definitely prevent aging. Apart from that, your body also ages because of destruction of cells. And what did I tell you for the recovery of cells? Protein. So in effect, I've actually taught you two very, very important things on how to prevent aging and how to live a healthier, a longer life is by preventing inflammation. And the second thing is by adding protein to your day-to-day diet. Followed, I'm going to take a break here now. And I am going to probably take some questions from people who are listening. If somebody wants to switch on their mic, if somebody wants to switch on their camera, if you want to ask me something, because I think isse zyada information ek sitting mein main dunga to seedha sar ke upar jayegi. Let's actually make it a little more interactive and let me hear what you have to say about what I've told you. How much omega-3 per day? Omega-3 per day, if you're writing down, omega-3 has two kinds of things. One is EPA and one is DHA. DHA वो बॉर्नविटा के एड्स में बताया जाता था, DHA फॉर दिमाग के विकास, बच्चे के दिमाग के विकास के लिए DHA खाओ. यू वांट टू कंज्यूम EPA. EPA 700 mg of EPA per day or more is the quantity of omega 3 you want to consume to really see visible differences. 700 mg of EPA per day or more is for real differences. That's the quantity of omega 3 you want to consume. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Would you suggest plant-based protein?
Definitely. So yeah. If you're not a non-vegetarian and most people are moving towards a plant-based diet, plant-based protein is all of your lentils and all of your pulses are definite plant-based proteins. They're completely plant-based, have nothing to do with an animal. So paneer and curd become animal-based proteins. If you want to move towards plant-based proteins, one, it is sometimes not possible to achieve your protein content purely from eating dals or soy because there are bad things said about soy. I think soya is a good thing to eat. So you've got all your lentils, you've got your pulses, and you've got soy. Along with that, you might want to probably add a protein supplement, jo powder lo khate hain, absolutely safe and absolutely clean.
So I was on that only, that the Nutrilite plant-based protein powder, which the Amway is distributing. Yeah. So how good is that? Do you recommend that?
So the reason why I recommend and don't recommend that product is because there are better products in the market. The thing with Amway and Nutrilite is that it's a very home brand. So most people automatically vest their trust in it because it's always been around. If you switch your vision towards a more fitness or a bodybuilding brand that is also giving you the plant-based protein, it's giving you better quality at probably the same price.
Which is what? Which company?
So there is this one company called Ace Blend.
A-C-E.
A-C-E. So Ace Blend is a new company that is giving you plant-based protein. Now, okay. You have to buy the plant-based protein jo aapke taste palette pe baithe, because plant-based protein is far less tastier than whey protein.
Yes.
So wo aapko experiment karna padega ki kaun sa wala aapko pasand aata hai. But anything which is giving you upwards of 20 grams of protein per scoop is good and you must take it.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure, but believe me, this protein number has to be hit every single day. And once you start hitting this protein number equal to your body weight for 3 months, you will see a difference in your energy level, in your recovery, in every single aspect of life. And no, consuming protein does not harm anybody's skin.
I have already seen it. I've used it in 6 months and it has worked on me.
Definitely.
Yeah. Thank you.
My pleasure, sir.
Yeah. There are further questions on the chat also.
Okay, how do you...
Can you please tell GNC name again?
Okay. GNC Triple Strength. That's the name of the omega-3 capsule that you want to buy from GNC. GNC Triple Strength. If you don't like the brand GNC, because certain people just don't like brands in general, the value of EPA that you want to hit is 700 mg per day. अब आप कोई भी ब्रांड खरीद लो, because you might think GNC might be giving him money to take GNC का name. No, you buy whatever brand you want to. 700 mg of EPA per day is want to do. Read the back of the label. उस label के पीछे सारी information written होती है. 700 mg EPA. As long as that is done, that's the supplement you want to take.
How do you measure protein grams like dal? I'm reading from the chat. They are not my questions.
Yeah, I can see them on the chat. So now measuring protein is something, or measuring food is something that all of us should know in general. Because, how do you measure protein? Google. Tumko ek weighing scale leni hai. Weighing scale pe ek vati ke andar uncooked raw dal dalo. Jitna measurement weighing scale pe likha hota hai, type it on Google. 75 grams of dal, how much protein? That is your answer. That is how you measure protein in dal. The problem with our katoris of dal is, and the mothers and the ladies over here will know this. When you cook dal for a family of four or for a family of six, you take ek mutthi dal, that's the amount of dal, or maybe do mutthi dal and you put it in the cooker, you boil it and that's the kind of dal you make. Ye jo dal hoti hai, ek katori mein na sirif 3-4 gram protein actually tumko de deti hai. And we think that, or chalo in certain households 5-6. My mom is in the fitness thing, so she also thinks that she's making a very protein rich dal. It's thick, but it's giving me 5 to 6 grams of protein per katori. Now we think that हम दिन में दो कटोरी दाल खा रहे हैं, and we always tell people हम दो कटोरी दाल दिन में खा रहे हैं, but that's 10 grams of protein, which for most average individuals is what? It's 16% of your daily intake of dal, and that is your primary protein source. उसके ऊपर तो आप कोई effort करते नहीं हो protein करने के लिए, because दाल ही आपका protein source है. So दाल जितनी ज़्यादा thick होगी, उतना ज़्यादा protein होगा, but it's not the tastiest thing to have a thick dal. That is why it is important to diversify. People, I have been told that the people at this club are very influential people, very affluent people. So everybody knows how to manage money. Money management mein portfolio diversify karte hain always, because that's how you protect your money and you grow your money the maximum. The same way you diversify your protein sources, because you cannot stick to one. You will get bored of it. So measuring protein, don't get into the psychology of measuring everything you eat. Wo pagalpan hai. Leave that to people like me. For you, just eyeball it and try and make simpler changes. So very thick dal and a secondary source of protein in the day, whether it is soya, whether it is tofu, whether it is chana, whether it is rajma, ye sabke salads bana ke bhi kha liye, very healthy, and pure family ko khilao. Okay, the next question is, how are supplements from Amway brand? They're okay. Most supplements from most brands are completely okay. There will only be one or two supplements that really, you know, go through the roof, and they are the names that, like the GNC Triple Strength. This is something that I have found to be better than the other ones in the market for the same price range. Now, I know price is usually not a factor for at least people living in our strata of society, but in general, nobody wants to splurge. Like, you don't want to waste your money. So GNC is one thing which is a good value for money and giving you the correct amount of things. How good is milk in your diet? I hate milk. Again, I don't believe in the concept of milk. I think milk is bakwas. I'll tell you why. I love dahi. I love paneer. I hate milk. I'm not going to go into wo wale ki, you know, cows and buffaloes ko inject karte hormones se. It's happening, and it's probably happened for the last 20 years, and it's going to happen for the next 100 years. Either you give up milk completely, or you accept the fact that that is the kind of milk that you're going to consume. Once you've accepted the fact, cut milk from your diet. The reason why milk is bad is because milk mein bahut 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 sara sugar hota hai. When you talk about sugar, now again, I saw this thing go up, the eyebrows getting raised by a couple of people. What does sugar in milk mean? Jab hum sugar ki baat karte hain na, every kind of sugar is the same. Chini, jaggery, honey, doodh, sare ke sare, everything that tastes sweet on your tongue is sugar, and everything that is sugar is the same. It's just a different mechanism of delivery. It's like honey is petrol and jaggery is diesel. Dono gaadi mein ja rahe hain, correct? That's this thing. Now when you talk about milk, milk bhi meetha hota hai. Milk meethi isliye hota hai because usme natural sugars hoti hain. All of us have been taught that natural sugars are good. Natural sugars are not good, they are accepted. The reason natural sugars are said to be good or accepted is because sugar, we all know sugar kharab hai. So agar koi upar se sugar dalega, hame pata hai wo galat cheez kar raha hai, but hame mithas ki aadat bhi hai, we're all addicted to sweet things. That is why we have found a way of justifying that to ourselves by saying natural sugar is good. It's not good, it's accepted. Isiliye jo tum fruits khate ho, fruits which are extremely sweet, and you're eating tons and tons of this food, they're not the best thing for you just because wo fruit hai. Just because it's a fruit and it's giving you some kind of nutrients does not make the sugar content in the fruit okay. So milk ko agar tum dahi kaise banate ho, tum doodh dahi jamate ho, there is bacteria in the dahi, the bacteria eats up the sugar of the milk to give you dahi. That is why mere hisab se dahi aur paneer is far superior to milk, because dahi aur paneer mein protein doodh jitna hi hota hai, calcium doodh jitna hi hota hai, probiotics doodh jitne hi hote hain, lekin chini doodh se zyada kam hota hai. Got it? So if somebody is going to take my conversation seriously, cut milk from your diet and switch to curd. In fact, yeah, definitely. How much protein should be consumed? Kavita ma'am, for the amount of protein, follow simple funda. Jitna aapka body weight hai, उतना आपको प्रोटीन खाना है. अगर आपका बॉडी वेट 50 केजीज है, आपको 50 केजीज खाना है. 60 60 70 70 80 80, मेरा बॉडी वेट 100 केजीज है, मुझे 100 केजीज खाना पड़ता है. बिकॉज आई एम सो लार्ज, I break more cells, so I have to recover more cells, so I need more protein. Very logical. Granola bars with protein, how good are they? If that granola bar is sugar-free, it's excellent. Because oats are a good source of carbohydrate, they're a good source of fiber, plus there's protein added in them. Correct? So it's a good option. Again, now we'll plug in my brand. I own a company called Food Darzi. Food Darzi has a parent, has a sister company called Baked Darzi. Baked Darzi is all about giving you breads, desserts, granolas in the most healthy manner possible. So that is where you can get your granola bars with protein. There, I plugged in my brand notes. So remember, I spoke about agenda. Everybody has an agenda. This was mine. I eat non-veg. Then also omega-3 capsules to be taken 100%. Non-veg is protein. Omega-3 is a fat. If you're a salmon eater, people who are fish eaters, if you eat a lot of fatty fish, if you eat salmon, if you eat cod okay. If you're a non-vegetarian who's eating a lot of fatty fish, then you probably don't need an omega-3 supplement. But otherwise, you need it. Can eggs are good for proteins? Very, very good. Eggs are excellent sources of protein along with the yolk. Half the protein of the egg is contained in the yolk. Half the protein is in the white. Yolk mein jo fat hota hai, wo aapko dil ka daura nahi dega. Dil ka daura aapko anek cheeze dengi, which I will cover. I will actually construct a heart attack in words for you so that everybody understands that consuming good fat is not bad. Or do you recommend sattu as a protein natural supplement? Yeah, why not? Sattu is the new trending thing because of certain, again, it is an agenda. Please understand everything's an agenda. Sattu is also agenda-based. Sattu is trending. I don't believe in sattu because I don't trust it as a very superior source of protein. But for somebody who's not taking other sources of protein, sattu is very good. Har cheez relative hoti hai. Rich to poor is a relative term. Sattu to paneer is a relative term. Sattu to paneer, paneer is better. But if you're not consuming paneer, sattu to kha hi lo because at least some amount of protein can enter your body. Theek hai? And most Ayurvedic naturopathy based practitioners have pushed sattu so much that sales of sattu have increased by, I think, 1,000,000%. The other day I was comparing, yeah. Because earlier sattu was just regarded as a Rajasthani atta kind of a thing. I'm Rajasthani, so I've known sattu all my life. But now it's mainstream. How good is a spoon of flaxseed oil? Very good. It is very good. But iska ye matlab nahi hai ki tum flaxseed oil pani ki tarah piyo. Flaxseed oil is fatty. Fat se aapka wazan badhega. So you have to make space for the flaxseed oil so that you don't increase your weight. But at the same time, flaxseed oil is a very good source of omega-3. Nut milk, very good. Almond milk, cashew nut milk, walnut milk, hazelnut milk. Bas bahar se mat lo. The reason I tell you bahar se mat lo is, jo unka nut milk hota hai na, usme, of course it is fortified with nutrients, but it is very, very thin. Agar tum almond milk bahar ka lete ho, ekdam patla banta hai. Tum ghar mein kabhi almond milk banane ki koshish karo. How is nut milk made? Tum almonds lo. Ghiste rao, ghiste rao, ghiste rao, ghiste rao. Keep grinding them and add water. That becomes your almond milk. It's as simple as that. Almond flour became very popular. Jab se keto zindagi mein aaya, almond flour became a huge deal. Almond flour is also badam ka aata. Badam ko mixi mein ghumao, that's your almond flour. Add a certain component of almond flour to your ghar ka aata. And that's how you're improving the health of your entire household. I'm not saying sirf badam ke aate ki roti banao, bahut bhari hoti hai. Add, make a mix and match. Is stevia a good sugar substitute? Yes, it is. Stevia is a good sugar substitute. Jo kg aur grams, protein ka grams tha. What has omega-3 for vegetarians? Flaxseed oil. Flaxseed oil has omega-3 for vegetarians. How is oat milk? Average. If you like the taste of oat milk, consume it. Oat milk is basically, it's okay. Like there is nothing very healthy about oat milk. There is nothing unhealthy about oat milk either. These different milk substitutes are coming up because there is a big industry that is pushing milk away from mainstream users. Isliye dusre kinds of milks are going to come in. So oat milk is also good milk to consume. Nothing bad about it. Aur batao. Ask me any question. I will have an answer to every single question that you ask me. And most of these answers are going to be a little different because they're true. The reason they're different is because they're true and they're not. I'll tell you one more instance. So of course, I deal with a lot of Bollywood. And the reason I deal with a lot of Bollywood is because of Food Darzi. It is a very convenient service for them. And that's what Food Darzi actually made me a celebrity nutritionist. Before that, I was just a co-founder of a startup. I'm a startup co-founder. That is what I am. At the age of 22, I started this company called Food Darzi, which by God's grace has grown on to become quite large in multiple cities, which a large valuation as well. So yes, we do make money at Food Darzi also, but I interact with a lot of Bollywood. Now that's when I realized that Bollywood stars and most people in general who go to famous dietitians are fed with a lot of wrong things. And they're fed with a lot of wrong things kyunki tumhe kuch alag bolna hai taki jo tumhe sun raha hai wo tumhari baat sune. Exactly what I did right now. I said certain things which were different so that you listen to what I'm saying. The only fact of the matter is that I'm speaking absolute truth, because if you Google every single word that I've said, you will find 100 research papers to support what I've said. Thyroid ke liye, bahut logon ne suna hoga, you know, don't eat cauliflower, broccoli, cabbage, peanut, ye sab mat khao. Any thyroid patients in the house? Koi na koi to hoga out of 34 people. Okay, I am a thyroid patient basically. Here, I have a scar. I recently got my thyroid gland removed. And the dietitian that was allotted to me, she did not know who I am. So she was telling me, you know, do not eat this and do not eat that. And I asked her why. She had absolutely no answer to it. They are propagating things because they have to tell you something different. And I'm propagating different things because I already have the answer to those different things. So with that kept in mind, let's ask me more questions. I love answering questions. Which ghee and oil should be consumed? Anything which is not vegetable based. So wo jo aapka sunflower, safflower oil hota hai na, vegetable oil, usko chhod ke aap koi bhi oil consume kar lo. ठीक है वो छोड़ के कोई भी ऑयल कंज्यूम कर लो एंड डू नॉट सिट विद दिस थॉट इन योर हेड दैट घी मेरे लिए बहुत ज्यादा पौष्टिक है. इट्स नॉट. आई कम फ्रॉम अ कीटोजेनिक बैकग्राउंड एंड आई रियली प्रोपोगेट घी एंड बटर बट देर नॉट न्यूट्रिशियस. देर जस्ट गुड. देर नॉट गुड. देर एक्सेप्टेड. देर इज नो नीड टू पुट एक चम्मच घी विद चावल एंड विद रोटी बिकॉज घी से तुम्हारा बहुत कुछ भला हो रहा है. नहीं हो रहा है. घी इज ओनली गिविंग यू एक्स्ट्रा कैलोरीज. ईट घी in certain places because it is decent for you but it is not good for you. Again, bachpan se, since our parents time, we've been thinking ghee is very good for you. It is accepted for you. It is not good for you. Ghee does not have any vitamins. Ghee does not have any minerals. And jo good fat bola jata hai, ghee se better fat exist karte hain. Nuts are better fats than ghee. Eggs are better fats than ghee. ठीक है. सो अगर घी खा रहे हो प्रमाण में इन 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 क्वांटिटी काउ मिल्क बफो मिल्क डजंट मैटर एनी. हाउ टू सब्स्टिट्यूट शुगर. आई लव डिजर्ट्स. यार दिस इज अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन बिकॉज आइदर यू कैन बाय योर डिजर्ट्स फ्रॉम बेक दर्जी और यू कैन यूज शुगर सब्स्टिट्यूट्स लाइक स्टीविया. और द थिंग विद स्टीविया इज दैट स्टीविया खाने के बाद ना आफ्टर टेस्ट में एक बिटर सा टेस्ट आता है, इसलिए लोगों को स्टीविया पसंद नहीं है. सो देयर इज समथिंग विच इज वेरी न्यू एंड वेरी गुड कॉल्ड मंक फ्रूट. MONKFRUIT. मंक फ्रूट इज एन आर्टिफिशियल स्वीटनर विच इज पार्शली नेचुरल. दे स्टिल हैवंट फाउंड एनीथिंग बैड अबाउट इट एंड इट रेप्लिकेट्स द टेस्ट ऑफ शुगर. सो मंक फ्रूट इज वन थिंग. Another thing, chalo, I'll leave it at monk fruit because then there's something called erythritol, which is a little technical, which nobody is going to buy. So monk fruit kharido. Is eating flax seeds healthy? Heaty for the body? Agar heaty matlab heat producing? No, heaty was a typo for healthy. Yes. What food can I use to help with hot flashes? Pradeep, is this, again, not being offensive, Pradeep, is Pradeep's wife on Pradeep's account or is it Pradeep? Because hot flashes usually happen with women between the age of 40 to 50 because they're undergoing either menopause or premenopause or perimenopause. Ideally, there is nothing that you can do to prevent the hot flashes. There will be a lot of nuskhe that come up and there are a lot of things that work for you because of course your mother, when you ask your mother, what can I do for hot flashes? She will tell you certain things which might work for you. You do those things that your mother or your sister or your best friend tells you because their experience. I am not a woman. I do not know what helps with hot flashes. The only thing that scientifically helps with hot flashes is hormone replacement, which a lot of females these days do. You delay your menopause by taking exogenous hormones and people are of the opinion that that should not be done. Let the body take the natural course. And women in the West have been doing it. I do not have an opinion on it because I am never going to have to do it. So consult your doctor, consult your elders, and whatever is acceptable to you and your family, do that. But hot flashes ka answer aapko apne female logo se hi milega. Mere paas nahi hai iska answer. What are your thoughts? I actually have the answer, but I don't want to interfere because मैंने अगर कुछ आड़ा तेड़ा यहाँ बोल दिया तो it is not going to be nice. What are your thoughts about Isabgol? Isabgol is beautiful. It is a very, very good natural fiber supplement. Everybody should take Isabgol after the age of 40 if you're even facing slight amounts of constipation, because constipation is that one thing which, when ignored, leads to very, very bad situations. And not passing a healthy stool every day, I wouldn't say morning because logo ka cycle kafi upar niche hota hai, but not passing a nice stool every day irritates. How many people have gone through constipation and that starts affecting their mental well-being? Because it is a real thing. It is people associate going to the bathroom and passing stools as a very nice thing that helps clear your system. Jinka nahi hota, unhi ko pata hota hai. So Isabgol low, along with Isabgol, Trifala is also something that you can start taking. Very healthy, very natural. My husband had a heart failure. What are the foods I should give him? Complicated question, because not one or two kinds of foods are going to prevent a heart failure. You basically need to just, if anybody has recorded this lecture, just listen to the first 20 minutes of this and follow it. That is literally what you have to do. Eat healthy and eat in certain portions and your husband will be absolutely fine. Another thing is you need to sort of understand, was the heart failure, was it like, of course, it's a larger conversation. Let's not discuss that, but just eat healthy. Overdo koi cheez ko nahi kar rahe, that's it. Is muesli good for breakfast? Which brand should we have? Muesli is good for breakfast, but try getting a sugar-free muesli, because muesli wale jo zyada popular brands hain, un brands ki muesli mein bahut zyada sugar hoti hai, because sugar is very tasty. So try getting a sugar-free muesli and that is very good for health. Your view to the trending intermittent fasting, very, very good. Intermittent fasting is, yeah, intermittent fasting is a great concept. But it is not a magic concept. Again, intermittent fasting is not a magic concept for the sole reason. A lot of people ne apna wazan ghataya hai intermittent fasting karke. Correct? Log kehte hain, I'm on intermittent fasting, mere 20 kilo kam ho gaye. Very normal thing that people have started saying around. The reason people have lost weight due to an intermittent fast is because log apna breakfast kaat dete hain aur apne dinner ke baad ke munchies kaat dete hain. मिडनाइट स्नैक खत्म हो गया, ब्रेकफास्ट खत्म हो गया, ऑटोमेटिकली कैलोरीज जो खा रहे हो कम हो गए, वेट लॉस शुरू हो गया. दैट इज व्हाई इंटरमिटेंट फास्टिंग गिव्स यू डिसिप्लिन. बट इंटरमिटेंट फास्टिंग शुड नॉट बी यूज्ड एज एन एक्सक्यूज टू ईट कचरा इन द आवर्स दैट यू आर ईटिंग. तुम ये नहीं बोल सकते कि आई विल स्टार्ट माई फास्ट विद रसगुल्ला एंड एंड विद गुलाब जामुन. चांस ही नहीं है. यू कैन नॉट डू दैट. ऐसा बिल्कुल भी गलत कॉन्सेप्ट है दैट यू कैन ईट, तुम्हें जितना भी खाना है तुम इंटरमिटेंट फास्ट में नहीं खा सकते. यू स्टिल हैव टू पोर्शन कंट्रोल. I eat a muesli mix which contains grains, oat seeds, nuts and dried fruit. Dried fruit is the problem. The fresh fruit is good. Dried fruit, so of course, nuts and dry fruits alag hote hain. Apricot, cranberry, dried berries, ye jo dried fruits hote hain na, ye sugar concentrates hote hain. I'll tell you why. Ek berry hai, theek hai? Is berry mein sirf itna sa sugar hai. Jab us berry ko tum dehydrate karke dry karte ho, wo berry itni si ho jati hai. Basically, the concentration of sugar in that berry increases. So, agar tum fruit ya berry kha rahe ho, fresh low, dried fruits itne achhe nahi hai. Dates are good, but your dried apricots and all of that are not the best thing for you. Thoda bahut kha loge, koi tension nahi hai. Ghee has more HDL na? No, it doesn't. Rajni and Pawan, ghee has absolutely no HDL. Zero. A lot of random websites will propagate that ghee has HDL. It doesn't. No food source can have HDL or LDL. HDL and LDL promoting cheeze hoti hain, like your omega 3 oils, your flaxseed oil, your avocados, your nuts, all of these things promote HDL production. Exercise, red wine promotes HDL production, but they do not create HDL, they promote the production. Even in certain situations, ghee jo bola jata hai, it is a saturated fat. घी और बटर में कोई फर्क नहीं है, सिवाय बटर तुम्हें कंटेनर में मिलता है. एट होम घी एंड बटर का डिफरेंस क्या होता है? तुम दही से या क्रीम से बटर बनाते हो, बटर को जब तुम उसका बटर मिल्क हटा के बटर के जो मिल्क सॉलिड्स को जब तुम गैस पे उबालते हो, दैट्स व्हेन घर का होममेड घी निकलता है. घी एंड बटर आर एब्सोल्युटली द सेम, देयर बोथ सैचुरेटेड फैट्स. एंड सैचुरेटेड फैट्स विल in certain people's Bible will cause cardiac illness, and in certain people's Bible it will not, but it is definitely not increasing HDL. Read up about it. If you don't believe what this boy is saying, don't believe me right now, read up about it. You'll get your answer. I have erythritol, yes, wife. Correct. I'm decoding messages here. Like, I've become so good at reading chats, I'm literally decoding messages. Yes, so erythritol, good. Pradeep Kabra's wife, yes. Ajay and Vinita Maru, air conditioner. Ye wala mujhse decode nahi hua hai. Ajay and Vinita Maru, air conditioner ka kya matlab hai? Hot flashes ka answer is air conditioner. Got it. Yoga will help, yes, it will. On an average, how much weight one should lose a month in a healthy way if I'm 80 kgs? The correct answer is 2 kgs a month. Who does a diet or who goes to a nutritionist or who pays money to a person who will make you lose 2 kgs a month? The smartest person on this chat right now. 2 kgs a month is the most healthy form of weight loss because this weight loss will never come back. As you start increasing the amount of kgs you burn in a month, you start burning more muscle, less fat. 2 kgs of weight is pure fat that I'm talking about. Again, it's technical. You should consult me. You should go to coachdarzi.com, which is the other company that I have where you can avail of my consultation services. Anyway, is quinoa for weight loss? Any food can be for weight loss. Weight loss is mathematics. Calories in, calories out. Tum bhale usme quinoa dalo, chicken dalo, oats dalo, sabzi dalo, doodh dalo, chini dalo. Again, I said chini. When you talk about weight loss, chini is different. When you talk about health, chini is different. Okay, last three questions. What is ideal for a male 6 feet tall? A girl that is 5 feet 10 inches tall? Matlab, because I'm a male who's 6 feet tall. No, but just kidding. What is ideal for a male 6 feet tall? It depends what your muscle mass on you is. Are you a muscular male? Are you a very thin male? What is your current weight? So I cannot answer a generic question because it wouldn't be right. Do you suggest that the dry fruit like almond and walnut should be soaked and consumed? It doesn't matter. You can consume it either way. My father is 76. He has severe gas issues. Your father, to the extent that he feels... Yeah. The reason he has gas issues, one is because at the age of 76, his metabolism has slowed down. Because his metabolism has slowed down, his intestines ka churning of food has slowed down. His digestive system has slowed down, is why he's having gas also. One thing is he is going to have to live with a certain amount of gas issues. And this is why I talk about lead a healthier, younger life so that your metabolism does not slow down at the age of 76, where your son or daughter really has to take care of you. That is basically why at this age, start increasing your recovery with protein and start increasing everything that you can do so that at the age of 76, you're completely independent, which my granddad is. My granddad got a knee replacement done 1 month ago. He is completely, and he's 87 years old. So it was not suggested for him to get a knee replacement at that age, but he hates being dependent on anybody. He's moving around completely normally. My granddad is also an ENT surgeon. He went to clinic till pre-lockdown. At the age of 87, he was seeing patients also. And that is because he has taught me so many of these concepts when I was younger, because he's lived through them. And my dadi hasn't. So I basically have the example and the control in my very own house, so I can see the difference between these two. So isiliye, father 76, one thing is start giving him fiber. Fiber for your father can either create more gas, because bacteria acts on fiber sometimes to create more gas, or on the other side, it can't. So you're going to have to experiment. There is something known as a red tea, which I have been giving to people. I forgot the name. I will message either Sanjay sir or Karthike sir the name, so you all can pass it on to Pooja ma'am. It is a tea which is really helping a lot of people with bowel issues. So I will message you. Pradeep Kabra, feel tired most of the time. What diet boosts energy? Okay, one, get your levels tested. Now here is when a vitamin or a mineral deficiency can come into the picture. If you're feeling tired, this could be the reason, your thyroid could be the reason. If all of that is checked and if you're feeling tired, then you need to start improving the activity level. Start taking a walk, start consuming food at shorter intervals, start consuming more energy dense foods. So more nuts, more dates, these kind of things. Things which are packed with energy in a small amount of food. Ye wale foods khao to give you more energy. Please share your Insta handle for healthy breads. It's called Baked Darzi. And my company is called Food Darzi. And my consultation company is called Poached दर्जी ठीक है सो प्रचार ऑल्सो डन अबाउट द कंपनी सो या दैट इज बेसिकली इट आई होप कितना टाइम हो गया यार नॉट बैड वी स्पोक फॉर वन आवर मतलब आई स्पोक फॉर वन आवर एंड आई एम नॉट इवन टायर्ड एंड आई होप यू गाइज आर नॉट बोर्ड and I hope the information that I gave you was valuable and yeah of course if you have any questions you can always ask me on Instagram or whatever because that is the place I spend most of my time on and yeah thank you for actually having me here and over to Smita ma'am
yes so it was a fantastic session thank you so much for your time and such practical advice such doable things I mean I guess we've taken back so much from this 1 hour that we've spent from you thank you so much I would like to invite Kavita for the vote of thanks please
hi Dr. Siddhant Bhargav I just wanted to tell you that your talk has been most insightful really exhaustive and backed with you know backed and corroborated by your science background since you're a doctor made so much of sense beautifully said everything and made so much of sense I myself am from the fitness background so a lot of the things that you have said I was actually jotting it down so I can tell my own clients I just wanted to tell you also that I heard about food darzi from the first time from my daughter-in-law she was also in Nayar Dr. Pooja Rathi
oh you're Aman's mom
yes I'm Aman's mom
I met Aman 3 weeks ago.
Okay. So I just wanted to tell you that I heard about food darzi when Pooja was taking your things and I saw the incredible difference it made in her. It was like too incredible, you know. So I'm saying, you know, I can tell all of you Rotarians firsthand that his products work. His food, his meals and everything, it actually works. So thank you so much, Dr. Siddhant Bhargav, for this superb talk of yours. From all of us Rotarians.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. How does it proceed? Is there? Do you all have like an internal thing going on?
No.
Done. Okay. Yeah. So I am finally going. I'm switching off my camera. And thank you everybody for attending this. And of course, if you have anything, you can always ask me. Wow. Bye bye.
Bye.
Yeah. The secretary announcements for today are: we had 37 logins, and the next. Meeting in October is the fellowship on the 30th October. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Lovely having you all here. Thank you, Doctor. And the meeting is now adjourned.
Really nice session.
Nice, it was. Nice session.
Yeah. Very, very well spoken.
Very interesting.
Yeah, very.